And that's awesome.
But what is a committee?
Yeah, but what does it really do? What I'm trying to get them to understand is how beneficial the, we call it the spiritual aspect of medicine, or the spiritual aspect of the complete care, the wholeness, but how well meditation and stuff like this really plays. The patients are hungry. Not even just the patients. Let's get to the staff. They want it. Mm-hmm. Medicine is stressful. Healthcare is stressful. Nursing staff, PCTs, like, just, they're all.
Is the leadership aware of the data? Not on the stress. I think they are aware of that. I'm just talking about, like, the benefits of meditation and practices.
I think it is such the soft target that they're not fully engaged in how beneficial it is. They are mm-hmm. not aware as what it can do. Mm-hmm. Which is silly, because the staff will tell you after a session, like, wow, right? And they're asking for more. Mm-hmm. Like, when are you going to start them again? When are you going to start them again? And so ultimately, what will be of greatest benefit is if they have somebody like me going from system to system, hospital to hospital, you know, on a pretty regular basis, you know, giving that the guidance that's needed to keep the mental aspect of the practice of medicine at ease, mm-hmm. right? To keep the stress low. You get the stress low, the staff works better, scores go up, safety is present, right? Because they're attentive, because they're not burnt out.
Yeah.
Right?
I can't tell you how many times I'll forget to meditate for a few days and just start feeling like this is
too heavy.
And then I meditate 10 minutes.
That's cool.
In the morning, 10 minutes at night, just put the world down for a second.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's just more tolerable.
You're